Listen, you get to make, I'm in the entertainment business, and we get to make different kinds of movies. Some are just purely for entertainment, and then sometimes you make a movie that culturally pushes the culture to a particular place. That sort of happens from the culture as well. I read the script, and I immediately felt, this is a story that we have heard, but it's time to revisit it again, and the culture is ready to revisit it, and we have this new pope, and there's a space open for this to really resonate in the world. And it's in those moments where film is used as a tool to teach, I think, and to coalesce ideas. And Mike, to reflect on what Michael said, it's just a great honor to be in the right place at the right time to be able to be part of that dialogue. It doesn't happen often in a career. It doesn't even happen that often in filmmaking, where you can really influence the conversation and push an issue in one direction or another, and this just happened to be one of those moments. I've always had a really healthy kind of respect for the press. You know, there's the gossip stuff, but I've never really taken that seriously. It's like a snack for people. I don't think people really take it to heart. They sort of eat, digest it, and poop it out later. And it's just like, sorry, if you're not you guys, just the gossip people.
For the record, you guys don't poop.
Yes, and I'm kind of a news junkie, and you know, I've also been in the trenches where on certain issues where we really relied upon journalism to help us move things in the right direction, and it was always, you're always sort of trying to find people that were willing to write a story about something that maybe wasn't popular, or give a spotlight to folks who you don't normally hear from. So I just have always held it in high regard, but what I got to learn from working with Mike and with Walter and the rest of the Spotlight team and the Boston Globe people was, you know, the deep commitment, what a deep commitment it takes, and what it costs to do it. And also Mike in particular was his just immense humanity. You know, to confront an issue like this in the way he did, you have to leave a lot of space open for people to be human, even if they're on the wrong side of this story. And that's how people will open up to you and talk to you. And he was so equanimitable. I sat at his side for days watching him work a story, watching him, hearing him on the phone, hearing him interview people. And I was fascinated by how much space he left for people, even on the wrong side of a story, to be able to write themselves, to be able to suddenly become part of the right side of the story. And keeping that space open made the story have much more nuance, and made the story... He convinced people to do stuff that wasn't directly within their interests based on the idea that you can do something to right what has been wronged. And that was remarkable. And that wasn't my general perception of a dogged reporter. I always think of a bulldog just hammering away until they get what they need. But he had a way of doing it that that was very... well, let's say this: he's gentle on the people and hard on the problem, and I thought that was a fantastic approach. And the guy's a master at what he does, and so I was very honored to be able to sit and watch how that worked and how important it was. And I saw him change legislation with two or three articles. He literally changed the state's legislation on a certain issue where people were being hurt. And he did that basically by himself. I mean, he had the globe behind him and the resources behind him. But I can't think of any other movement or groups of people or communities that can affect that much change in that precise a way in such a short period of time. And that's why it's so important that we have journalism.